5G communication is coming to a reality. Today, most of country launches 5G already. However, most of them are enabled FR1, that is sub 6 GHz band as the first wave. Now, mmWave FR2 is becoming more and more important. However, to develop or to prototype a 5G mmWave communication system is not an easy task. TMYTEK, we already built up great devices to help you in this job. In today's take, we are going to introduce our beamformer, BBox, and up-down converter, UD Box, to work with a very popular SDR and to show you how our devices can help you in research. Let me introduce the lab setup here. First, I will introduce the devices used in this setup, and then we will get into the lab section. First, introducing BBox. BBox 1 is a 2D array with 4x4 array size. This is BBox Lite. BBox Lite is a 1x4 beamformer, also developed by TMYTEK. UD Box stands for Up-Down Conversion Box. The purpose of UD Box is to up-convert or down-convert the signal from mmWave spectrum to IF band. Next, I'd like to introduce baseband. The baseband instrument we are using today is from National Instrument. As an SDR platform, it's very flexible to edit the waveform you like to test with. Actually, you are free to connect to any SDR. There's no limitation here. The setup here is we are using BBox 1 as transmitter, BBox Lite as receiver. The baseband signal or waveform is come out of the NI instrumentation, get into UD Box and up convert to mmWave. So the mmWave signal come out here, go through cable to BBox. Then the beamformer of the BBox will transmit the signal over the air. The distance between TX and RX is 1 meter. Whenever receiver receives the signal will be come out of the COM port and going through cables and feed it back to UD Box. Then the signal will down convert to IF band again and feed into NI instrumentation. So basically, that's how it works in this setup. Let's check link budget here. The output power from transmitter is minus 5 dBm. After cable, minus 1. And the conversion loss of UD Box is 12 dB. So minus another 12. The signal will then fit into BBox through RF cable. The cable loss is minus 5. Here we are using 2 segments of the RF cables. The gain of BBox 1 is plus 37. So in total, the output from BBox 1 is 14 dBm. The distance between BBox 1 and BBox Lite is 1 meter. And then the loss is approximately minus 61 dB. So 14 minus 61 dB. The power received by BBox light is minus 47 dBm. The gain of BBox light is 28. So minus 47 plus 28 is minus 19 dB. Again, the cable loss from the IF cable is minus 5, and another 12 dB is lost in UD box. Finally, the IF cable will contribute another 1 dB loss. In the end, the received power from baseband is minus 37 dBm. Introducing software. In this experiment setup, we are using two pieces of software. The first one is from NI. The software provides the interface to edit a waveform and to measure the received power, then showed up the constellation diagram. We are using 5G new radio FR2 waveform with a 256 QAM signal modulation. As you can see, the constellation diagram here is quite beautiful. And here in this chart is the spectrum of the receiver. Another software is provided by TMYTEK. We call it TMX Lab. Here is the software interface of TMX Lab. The interface can be used to control both the BBox One, BBox Lite, and the UD Box. Our software supports basically all of our devices. The screen shown up now is the control interface for BBox One. There are 16 channels, so you are able to control each channel, the phase and amplitude independently. Also, TMYTEK, we provide a very innovative and intuitive user interface. That is a 3D beamforming, as you can see from the screen here. You can control the beam direction just easily by dragging the beam and moving it around. That is a very intuitive way to control beam. So when you move the beam around, you can see the amplitude and the phase of each channel has been changed accordingly to reflect the change of the beam direction. What we are going to do is to change the beam direction by drag the beam in a graph. And then we will see how the signal has been impacted from the result of constellation diagram. At the beginning, both BBox are pointing to 0 degree. This is usually called bullseye. So when both BBox align in the bullseye direction, then we get the best power and signal to noise ratio. So that's why we get the best EVM result here. Now, we will move the beam of BBox One somewhere else. You will see the constellation diagram is broken. So basically, the signal quality is lower. Two beams from BBox One and BBox Lite, they are not aligned. So we'd like to prove this part. Now I'm trying to move the beam of BBox One intentionally to 20 degree in azimuth direction, that is 5. And then we will see how we can recover the signal by moving the receiver part, that is BBox Lite, physically to 20 degree. And then the signal is going back. The simple experiment here showed up a great platform and excellent features to show you how easy you can control the beam. And you can set up the whole setup to start your millimeter wave innovation today. Please remember, visit tmytech.com and subscribe our YouTube channel and download data sheet here.